Hey, it's Katie with Picture Perfect Lawn Maintenance. I'm back for part 2 of 3 in our Plus Package series that talks about all of the preventative care that you can get in an additional package to your standard maintenance care for your lawn. Today we are going to be talking about grubs and what we can do to prevent them from destroying your lawn. So if you haven't already, be sure to check out our Nuts Edge Control episode of this series that talks about how to reduce the impact of Nuts Edge on the appearance of your lawn. Nuts Edge is pretty straightforward because it's a weed that's mostly a cosmetic issue, and the control of it is elective simply because it's a matter of whether or not it's in your budget and if it's a priority to you. Grubs are a little bit more complicated because it's not so much a cosmetic issue as it is a health of your turf issue. So when we talk about lawn grubs, also commonly known as white grubs, we're talking about the larval stage of local beetles. Now, this is only a select genus of beetles. Hashtag not all beetles. The beetles we're primarily concerned with when we talk about lawn grubs are in the Phyllophaga genus. You might be wondering, why does that matter? And it doesn't. Not for you. It doesn't matter for you. It's just something worth knowing. What matters a little bit more is the common names that some of these beetles are referred to so that it's easier for you to identify them. In the Phyllophaga genus, in the RVA area, we are mainly paying attention to June beetles, May beetles, and Japanese beetles. The larval stage of all of these beetles are really identifiable based on their appearance. As their common name would suggest, white grubs are primarily white in color. They have these orange little heads and these orange little legs up close to their heads, and then they make kind of a C shape. That's bad. You shouldn't do that. And then their big meaty body makes kind of a C shape that maintains this curve that is really easy to notice when you're digging through dark soil. Where your lawn is concerned, that C shape stands for carnage. These grubs feed on the roots of your lawn during the summer like crazy. It's their main food source, along with decaying organic matter in the soil system. And the life cycle of these grubs and these beetles is pretty simple. Around late spring, early summer, adult beetles lay eggs 1 to 8 inches in the surface of the soil. After a few weeks, these eggs hatch and they become early stage larvae that proceed to feed on the roots of the grass for the remainder of the warm season. The larvae then burrow deep into the ground where they can overwinter at a depth that isn't going to be affected by freezing temperatures. The following spring, they come back up to the surface layer where they spend all summer eating on those roots, and the cycle continues to repeat. For June beetles, it is a several year process of feeding as a grub, burrowing down to overwinter, coming back up, feeding as a grub, going back down, until eventually in the spring, it'll enter its pupal stage before it emerges as an adult. For June bugs and May beetles and all of them, they then spend an additional winter overwintering in the ground before they finally reemerge in the summer as adults to repeat the process. For Japanese beetles, it's actually just a 1 year cycle, so they only go through one overwintering process. Even though the duration of this life cycle can vary between different members of the Phyllophaga genus, the big important thing is that they are most active and at the surface layer during the summer. That's the important takeaway from this 7th grade biology lesson that I've just given you. The best time to apply grub control treatments is going to be in the summer. Now, depending on the product you're using, the area you're in, and how much rain you're getting that season, this summer timing range can range from as early as May to as late as August, possibly outside of that, just depending on what's going on. But that's why it's important to take all of these factors into consideration with anything that you do in lawn care. At Picture Perfect, most of the time we are applying our grub control as a single application in late May, early June timeframe, just depending a little bit on the weather, but right there around the very end of spring and beginning of summer. It is pretty straightforward to apply your own grub control. It's definitely something that a homeowner can do with proper coaching and understanding of the product that they're using, ideally with a professional company like Picture Perfect, kind of coaching you from behind the scenes on exactly what your application rate and timing should be. Now, as you know with this series, grub control is something that is included in our Plus package that offers ancillary supportive services to your typical fertilizer program. However, if you don't experience problems with nuts edge or with fungus, then the grub control is still available as a standalone treatment depending on your priorities and needs. If you have ever seen June bugs or Japanese beetles in your lawn areas, in your bushes, and keep in mind, once those grubs become adult beetles, they are eating your ornamental plants, so that's just one more reason to keep them under control. But if you've been seeing these adult beetles, or if you dig in your yard and you find multiple of these white grubs, these larvae, then you are probably going to be a good candidate for grub control. I am not exaggerating when I tell you about the immense amount of damage, the carnage, that these grubs can do to a fescue lawn. Too strong of a population of grubs is going to wipe out the root system of your lawn to the point where you can roll up the surface layer of the turf like carpet. At any point of the year, but especially summer, this is going to be tragedy for your lawn because it has to have that root system to survive the heat and any kind of drought. The grubs are a threat to your root system, but your dog might be a threat to your surface layer turf. She's having fun. If you are applying grub control to your own property or to properties of any clients that you maintain as a professional, odds are that the product that you are using is not going to be especially pollinator friendly. As a result, it's really important to just go ahead and mow any lawn areas that you're going to be treating with grub control prior to putting the product down so that there aren't any clovers or any wildflowers that could attract pollinators like bees and possibly expose them to something hazardous. You know me, I love my bees. It's just something to keep in mind. It doesn't hurt to be conscientious. In fact, it's the right thing to do. I hope this video has been helpful to you to understand what grubs are, how to identify them, and the risk that they pose to your lawn, as well as how beneficial it can be to have preventative grub control built into your program. Remember, we still have a few weeks before we need that last call of people in who are wanting to get on the schedule for grub control. If it's in the budget, it's a great idea, and since it's a single application and can make a huge difference, it's in most people's budget and it's going to be in your benefit as well. So be sure to hit me up, send me an email, give me a call, send me a text message. You guys know how to get in touch with me if you're a Picture Perfect client. But let's work together to make sure that this is the most successful year yet. As I mentioned before, we are seeing unprecedented picture perfection in our lawns this spring, thanks to Carbon X that we've been building into our program. We love this product so far. It smells good and it's making the lawns look amazing. So if you haven't already, be sure to check out our information on this round two application of fertilizer and weed control so you can stay up to date on what's happening in your lawn. I appreciate you guys watching. If you found this video on Facebook, be sure to check out our YouTube channel where you can like and subscribe and ring the bell, whatever that even means. And if you're already watching us on YouTube and you haven't already, subscribe. What are you waiting for? And go check out our Facebook page, check out our Instagram. We have so many great looking lawns that we are flooded with pictures. So be sure to follow us, stay up to date, enjoy the weather, and hey, wait, did you notice? I sound a little different, don't I? And how about all of this ridiculous wind, right? And yet you can still hear me because the Easter Bunny brought me an awesome new microphone for our camera. We're really, really excited to be able to improve the quality of our videos and not irritate the other YouTube contributors that might be following this channel. I'm not a professional yet, but I am getting there. So be sure to stay tuned. We've got the last part of the series coming up in a couple of days, and it's gonna be all about fungus. And to me, this is one of the biggest things that we can be talking about this year due to all of the rain and the high risk that our lawns are at for fungus this season. I appreciate you guys watching, and I hope you have a picture-perfect day.